two. Now, Folkwang and the Royal Conservatoire of Scotland, we are full of gratitude to both institutions for facilitating this collaborative project, which has just grown organically, like all of the best projects. All of the old instruments being played today by the students are from the John Webb collection of historic brass instruments at the Conservatoire in Glasgow. They are kept in the whisky bond at the end of the Forth and Clyde Canal, a very interesting place to visit if you ever get the chance. And we're also very grateful to the amazing brass students here at the Folkwang for their enthusiasm for these old instruments and the sounds that they produce. And lastly, this project couldn't have happened without Tony George, a Offaclyden bass player, who drove the instruments in two trips from Glasgow to Essen via the overnight Hull to Rotterdam ferry. He's full of testing and everything, but he managed it. So thanks to Tony. We are starting our concert with the first original piece for brass band by Joseph Parry, the Tidful Overture. This was written sometime in the 1860s or 70s. Joseph Parry, the Tidful Overture, conducted by Bede Williams.
Thank you.
So that was the Tydfil Overture by Joseph Parry. And I was just thinking during that performance that that was probably the first performance in Germany over 150 years after it was first composed. And so Joseph Parry wrote this for the Cyfartha band in Merthyr Tydfil in South Wales. And the Cyfartha band was founded by Robert Crawshay, who was an iron and steel magnate and owned most of the South Wales coal field. And the Industrial Revolution, coal, iron and steel, swept all the way over Europe, even to here. And this area here in Essen on the Ruhr was in the heart of 19th century industrial Germany. It doesn't look like that these days. It's so green. Now, where industry and the railroad network spread, so music and brass instruments spread too. Now, Hector Berlioz was one of the great composer champions of all of these new brass musical instruments. But he needed to come to Germany to get the best performances of his works. He wasn't taken as seriously in his native France as he was in Germany. And in his letters, he writes about the best valve trumpet player in the world, Ernst Saxe, who played in Franz Liszt's orchestra in Weimar. I think he was hired by Hummel, and then Liszt took over in the mid-1830s. Well, rather incredibly, Saxe played the trombone too, and we're going to hear his own trombone concertino next. Now, he played it both in Weimar and with the Leipzig Gewandhaus Orchestra in the 1830s and 1840s. So here is Ernst Saxe's trombone concertino, arranged for brass by Tony George, played by Christian Koenig.
Thank you. Thank you. So, like...
Aha, thank you. Aha, caught you by mistake. Aha.
So, like musicians of today, 19th century musicians were portfolio musicians. They used to do lots and lots of different things. They would be playing in a military band on a salary. They would be teaching at a music conservatoire on a salary. They would be playing in an orchestra on a salary. And they would be doing all sorts of other things. This is because in the 19th century, as in today, the musician's life was always insecure. You were always one bad concert away from not having a salary anymore. But luckily, in this amazing festival, we've only heard amazing concerts, so we are all secure. Now, we are going to be playing another piece by Mimart. Now, some of you who were here yesterday may have heard me say that Mimart was one of these undiscovered composers. We still don't really know an awful lot about him. We know that he went to Japan as a sailor. We know that he was given the Legion d'Honneur as a band conductor, and we know that he wrote a septet, which included a bass saxhorn, which Paul is demonstrating, a small bore trombone-ish, which Chris has in his hand. We have a petit bugle, which you saw yesterday in the Bellon. We have a normal cornet, which we also saw yesterday in the Bellon. We also have a flugelhorn, which is a big version of the little bell, of the little flugel. But we also have this instrument here, which is called a saxotromba. Now, we found out today from Professor Arnold Myers that all these instruments are quite distinct, which is why we play them. Because in this ensemble, every instrument has its own voice, and they blend together, but they're also very different. Keep that in your mind as you enjoy Mimart's second septet.
Thank you.
So now we are joined by all of our lovely new friends from not just this wonderful Folkwang Institute, but also from this wonderful global breath, fantastic, amazing jamboree of deliciousness. Now, the next piece we are going to play is an arrangement. And arrangers are incredibly important. They're so important to one man in the 19th century called Robert Thompson Crawshay, who was a little bit like Jeff Bezos, incredibly rich and very modest. Now, Robert Thompson Crawshay decided that he wanted the best arranger for brass bands in the world. And so he brought him over from France, put him in a little house at the bottom of his garden, and said, go and arrange. And so he did. Now, the only problem, although it wasn't so much of a problem for Robert Thompson Crawshay, but the problem was for George Dartney, for it was he who was the arranger, was that he liked to be paid in alcohol. And he spent his entire arranging career pretty much drunk. But he arranged incredibly well. The parts, they will only have one key signature at the very beginning of the music. There were very, very few mistakes. The band didn't like very much sharps. In fact, none of the music has many sharps in it. So instead of being in E major, which as we all know has got four sharps, Dartney would write in F flat major, much easier, with B double flats and F flats, and only one key signature at the beginning. So these musicians were incredible because they could remember that. They were absolutely exceptional. We have now been joined by all of our colleagues. So over to Bede, who's going to be conducting this beautiful piece called The Lost Chord.
Thank you.
So thank you to Ivan Maltsev for that wonderful flugelhorn playing. He was playing on a Zun flugelhorn from Rotterdam, which was actually the first instrument that John Webb ever bought. He was a designer and a cartoonist, so and he worked in Holland for a while before he came back to England. So that was Sir Arthur Sullivan's Lost Chord. Arthur Sullivan, better known for his Savoy operettas like the Gondoliers and the Mikado, which are still very, very popular in Great Britain. Now, that solo, John Miller and I, John Miller, have been playing in bands together since he was 5 and I was 7. And I can tell you, it feels like a very long time ago. And that was the first solo that we ever played. Bands and brass players love competitions. And when we were little, we used to go in for competitions every weekend, practically, solos and quartets and things, which they had at the local miners' welfare institutes, which were all over central Scotland at the time. And that was everybody's favorite solo. You had to play it. So Ivan, you're in very good company and you played it fantastically. I don't think we ever got near that, didn't we? Of the poetry that that piece needs. Of course, we were very young at the time and you do have experience on your side. So to close our concert tonight, we're going to play the first original piece of music for brass band by a female composer, Charlotte Sainton Dolby. She was so unusual at the time that I think on the parts it's marked Madame Sainton Dolby. Now, Charlotte Sainton Dolby was Mendelssohn's favorite contralto in England and did the first performance of Elijah in Birmingham. I think you call it Der Elias or something, yes. But they sing it in English in England, and it was given its first performance in Birmingham in 1846. And Mendelssohn conducted it and Charlotte Sainton Dolby sang. So she wrote this triumphal march, as it's called, for the Cyfartha band in Wales in around 1860. It's a terrifically subtle march with a very gentle trio. And I know you're going to enjoy this triumphant end to our triumphant project. Thank you.